This is so exciting. Where is Elias going to find Olai?
Where is Olai, wonder? I think, do you know where Olai is? Where is he?
It's Ivy Barn.
Yes, let's see where they find Olai.
Okay, so the book we're going to read today, the story for today is Elias and Duck, Search for Olai. One night, we have Elias. Who is Elias? Oh, here he is in bed, snuggled up in bed, and thanking Olai for his mother, for his father, and his best friend, Duck. You see, Duck is next to him sleeping. Duck is his best friend. Elias tries to close his eyes and tries to go to sleep and thinks, thank you, Olai. But where is Olai? Next morning, Elias is outside looking up. Duck comes to him. Quack, quack, quack. Elias, what are you doing? What are you looking at? I'm looking for Olai, Elias told him. Said the duck. Quack, quack, quack. And then he went back to the house. And he started looking in the toy box. Quack, quack, quack. And then he came back. Here, Elias, he said, try these binoculars. Wow, he's given him a binoculars. So he can see very far with it. Elias looked through the binocular. He could see the clouds. He could see the birds far away. He could see a plane flying away. There was Hoodhood sitting on a branch. Hoodhood said, you can't see Olai with those binoculars. What do you mean? Asked Elias. But Hoodhood didn't answer. It just flew away. Quack, quack. Maybe we need to be closer to the sky to see Olai, Duck told Elias. Okay, said Elias. So they started getting ready and packed all their things. They were going to go high, high on top of the mountain. On top of the mountain, they saw an alpine ibex. What are you doing here? Ibex said. We're looking for Olai, said Elias. Do you know where we can find him? Yes, said the ibex. He had really long horns on his head. Olai is all around us. He made the mountain so tall. But you can't see Olai like you can see me. What do you mean? Said Elias. But the ibex didn't answer. It just went away. Maybe Olai is somewhere in the ocean? Quack, quack, said Duck. Said Elias. Okay, so they put their swimming suit on, their goggles on, and they went in the ocean. There they saw an anglerfish. We're looking for Olai, said Elias. Do you know where we can find him? Yes, said the fish. Olai is all around us. He's everywhere. He gave me gills so I can breathe in the water. But you can't see Olai like you can see me. What do you mean? Asked Elias. But the anglerfish didn't answer. It just swam away. Swish, 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 swish. Maybe Olai is in a rainforest in the jungle. Quack, quack, said the duck. Said Elias. Okay. So they went to the jungle. Then they saw a mandrill.
We're looking for Allah,
said Ilyas.
Do you know where we can find him?
Yes,
said Mandrill. He was a colorful monkey. Allah is all around us. He gave me colors. But you can't see Allah like you can see me.
What do you mean?
Asked Ilyas. But the mandrill didn't answer. He just swung away. Maybe Allah is in outer space. Quack, said Duck. Said Ilyas. So they went on a rocket and got ready to go to outer space. There they saw so many beautiful stars and the earth below. Wow, this is amazing, said Ilyas. Subhanallah. It sure is, said Duck.
Quack.
But where is Allah?
I think I know the answer, said Ilyas. Now I understand what all the animals were trying to tell us about Allah.
What do you mean, quack, quack, quack?
Well, Duck, Allah made the whole universe, the whole world, everything else that we see. He made the mountains, the water, he made you, and he made me. But we can't see Allah like we can see each other. We can see his creations and the beautiful things he made, and we know Allah is there. Subhanallah. That night, Ilyas was very happy. He closed his eyes and began to smile because he learned about Allah and that Allah was all around him.
Kudafis, hope you enjoyed. Thank you for joining us. Kudafis.